question my car. Nigga, school up, nigga. Uh oh, that cool up. Shut the fuck up, nigga. Slap the shit out you, nigga. Say school up, nigga. Turn up. Hey man, kick your fingers. Look man, I think I had one too many blunts today.
What the fuck?
Too many bills and I'm drunk today. I drunk a pint of lean, so I'm wasting mine. I got the gangster in, nigga, you can taste it, man. I'm serving, nah. All of my niggas be serving, squad. Pull up to the curb, curb service. What you want, nigga, we work,
yeah, we got it.
I'm serving, come through with my Bentley, I'm swerving. Close the fucking curses. Whoa. What's happening?
There's some shooters in the house. There's a whole bunch of shooters in the house. There's some shooters in the house. There's some shooters in this house. If you wanna go to war, fuck it, nigga, let's shoot.
Scream.
Walk up in my spot, sit down, have a seat. I just been in 5 shootouts last week. He bought the wrong division, plus he moving in the kitchen. Nobody make a move, nigga, when Scooter handling business. Reaching in his pocket, Gucci slap him with the pistol.
Get your bitch ass down, nigga. Motherfucking move, nigga.
Hood rich.
Brick up to your sister, I'm a thunder and a runner. I don't give a damn about it, but I'll make niggas with the thunder. I got money in the fender, trying to buy my kids crisps. Me and Scooter ain't twins, but we got twin choppers. Now I walk a flock of flame, a nigga hit him with the yop. I'm a street nigga, never be a partner to a cop.
No, what the fuck going on, nigga? Who the fuck let the police say, nigga?
I don't know.
Fuck out the spot, nigga.
Yo. It's CEO. See the school out. Huh. I woke up a legend. I went to sleep a legend. I just signed legend.
Break dancing. Break a 9-piece off a brick and make it break down.
Chopper got you spinning on your head like you break down.
My pistol in the club with me, I don't wanna break down.
Smack a limo, make a nigga script like you shake down.
My favorite weapon, Mac 11, black and rip and left 11.
What's so broken, 97, pray the brick would come from heaven.
Nigga used to laugh when I walked from Boulder Crest to Grush. So who's laughing last? I just pulled up in a 9-11. Money don't make me close, don't make me. A lot of people still ain't heard of me. They used to just know me locally. Now they know me globally. Atlanta overlook apartments, just came back from overseas. If I can do it, you can do it. You started with more than me. Mom couldn't really do much for me. So bro used to eat lunch for free. Backstabbed so many people that my boss won't even pass the blind to me.
This beat is so rich.
Call me Jermaine when I'm on the stage with you. But call me Jesse James when I hold this damn pistol. You can call me Gucci Guwap when I do a song with you. But don't walk up on me, homes. I ain't finna blow no scroll with you. Got them young shooters with me, they don't get along with you. If you ain't get no money, nigga, what is wrong with you? And I can't tell you all, niggas have the wrong pitch. I'm in the field sipping lean with this very long switch. I'm drinking methazine and codeine and this apple juice mixture. If you knew that you would do that, I swear you would not kill. Use a Nicky Barnes nigga trying to tell on God fish. If a snitch was to die today, I bet his hood would not miss.
Use a dead man, playing games with that bread. Use a dead man, I put that pistol to your head, man. Dead man, you playing games with my bread, you in the red man. Fuck around and be a dead man, dead man.
This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back.
You take the blue pill. The story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland. And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
American. But anyway, I've had people calling me saying they go out to their mailbox and they find a little red dot or a little blue dot on their mailbox and they wonder what the little red dot and blue dot is. Well, it's marking your mailbox by the government, so when foreign troops come in here on us after martial law, if you have a red dot on your mailbox, they take you out immediately and shoot you right in the head. But if you have a blue dot, they take you to the FEMA camps being built by Halliburton right now to house 50 million Americans. They're building enough concentration camps in America.
Mike Will.
Mike Will.
I can't even sleep, I got so much.
A man is building an ark. He doesn't think he's the new Noah, but he does think the Bible story may in fact be factual, and he wants to open a theme park to make the case. However, is there any real science here, and should taxpayers be funding this thing? Here's ABC's David Wright.
It's every kid's favorite Bible story, Genesis chapter 6 to 9, the story of Noah and the flood, and the ark he built to save all the animals two by two. An apocalypse rendered kid-friendly for Sunday school.
I'm Father Noah, captain of this bark.
This story, like so many stories in the Bible, has big elemental things that are still leave questions in the world today.
After Jesus and Moses, Noah probably has more Hollywood blockbusters.
Raise the raft, lads!
Than anyone else in the Bible. Which is why we found ourselves in an unlikely place.
So we are in Williamstown, Kentucky. Population, not much by the looks of things. And where we're headed is supposed to be right up here.
We turn a corner and lo and behold.
There she blows.
Off in the distance is a large wooden ship still under construction.
Oh my gosh.
Noah's Ark right here in the American South.
510 feet long, 85 feet wide, 51 feet high.
The dimensions set out in the Bible, cubit by cubit. Ken Ham is the Noah of this ark.
It's huge. The closer you get, it just looms.
It gets bigger and bigger.
Ham is no Old Testament prophet. His mission? To turn this Bible story into a world-class theme park, straight out of the Old Testament, and then some.
The message that we have, it's making the Bible come alive. Really, by building Noah's Ark, we're saying,
this really happened. This is plausible.
When finished, Ham says his ark will be 7 stories tall and a football field and a half long, the largest timber frame structure in the world.
Taking it like a dash, right?
I was leaning when I wrote this, so forgive me if I don't go too fast.
I shop off the internet. I don't go to the store. You motherfuckers think I go to the store? I just hit the butt, and shit just come to the house.
But the police pulled me over in a Ferrari with the paper tag.
What you doing, cooking meth in the damn house, homie? What you got going on, man?
36 years young, got 30 kids, all rappers, producers and DJs. I'm living the life.
Your man, Cool Wop, doing this interview with Fader, man. Shout out to Fader Magazine. I appreciate y'all. Life in prison was hell, you know. And if I can do it all over again, you know, I think that it helped me a lot to get to the point I am now. You know, since it dried me out from the drugs, gave me time to reflect, you know. Made a lot of relationships that were just toxic in my life. Just fall away and just set up a boundary for when I got out. But at the same time, it was a maximum security prison. And, you know, people were dying every week. You know what I'm saying? It was a lot of death, a lot of violence. I'm a celebrity, but at the same time, I feel like I'm a hell of a man. And, you know, besides being a celebrity, you know, I'm just gonna always handle myself like a man. And it don't take people long to see that. And that's how people gonna have to approach me. Period. Whether I'm in jail, whether I deal with the police, whether I deal with anybody, you know, my probation officer, I'm gonna always be a man. So I never been fond of just letting people take advantage of me or handle me any kind of way, so that'll never happen. I think I've been sophisticated. I've been super smart. When I was on drugs so bad, you know, I talked different. You know, when I was smoking weed, damn near a pound of weed every other day, you know, I was congested. When I was drinking lean like crazy every day, I was out of my mind. So it ain't even a sophisticated, it's just a sober, a more conscious Gucci. And then people probably ain't used to it. I'm not, you know, it took a minute for me to get used to it. But you know, after you've been sober 3 years, it's like I done adapted to it. I gotta give them time to adapt to it. Cause they gonna have to get used to it cause it's here to stay. Gucci Mane will come. Yeah, I heard that same rumor. It's funny to me. I guess that, you know, people ain't used to me being healthy and taking care of myself and being happy. So I can understand why they shocked, you know what I'm saying? So it's funny. I embrace it. It just let me know a clone is like perfection. So if I look like a machine or a robot, then evidently I'm doing something well.
There he is.
Yeah. What's going on?
Now, without being like on some sentimental stuff, you know what I mean? Every time we interview, we always gotta reiterate that, you know, we've been messing with each other, no home over for some years.
Y'all held me down, you know what I'm saying?
No matter what.
When y'all first came here, man, y'all embraced me off top, man. You know, I just told my folks, I said, you know, this ain't no laughing matter. I gotta hurry up and get up to the station. These my boys.
I told her, you know, your assistant called me today, and I was like, you know, there's certain people in the industry that I jump for. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah. And it is what it is. You know, yeah. What I mean, I don't sugarcoat it, and I don't try to lie about it. Mm-hmm. you, Waka, mm-hmm. you know, your whole family.
Yeah.
Whenever y'all ask me to do something, I try to break the rules a little bit. Try to
we bend always
it.
Break the
you
rules.
Know what I'm saying? And when it comes to Gucci Mane and what you got going on, whatever you got going on, whether it's looked at as good or bad, I don't, that's not my, the judge. I'm just here as a vessel for, you know,
yeah.
tell my partner, because when we yeah. was coming up in radio, you was one of the only people that said, I'm messing with y'all.
Yeah.
I'm going to come interview with y'all. I'm going to come do this yeah. with y'all. You know what I'm saying? And so I don't really look at the whole political side of stuff. Mm-hmm. I look at the loyalty things.
Yeah.
And I believe that that's what's kind of missing in the game, man. I'm just kind of glad that you've got this, you've always kept this crazy buzz musically. And even with your team now, with you know, with you signing Scooter mm-hmm. and the other artists you have mm-hmm. on your team, it's all you're never not busy.
Yeah.
You know, and as an independent label, man, I mean, what do you contribute that to?
First off, I like to say I appreciate that, you know what I'm saying, because it means a lot to me, too, because you and Jay Nix been down with, you know what I'm saying, and I do appreciate y'all loyalty, because y'all always were up for the squad. But on another note, me being just an independent artist, you know, even though, you know, me and Big Cat, you know, severed our ties and went different ways, I still got a lot of respect for him because he showed me a lot. I learned a lot from him.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, just to be honest, you know, I do pat him on my record label a lot of, by all the good things I seen him do. Now the bad things he did, I learned not to do that with my artists.
Right. Mm-hmm. And now that you got Scooter, like what's gonna be the next move with him? Because I mean, you've got some people underneath your gun. I mean, you know what? I'll say this. Mm-hmm. I remember Nicki Minaj.
Yeah.
And I remember her being there with y'all and y'all saying, yo, I got this female artist and blah, 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 and all this stuff. And I remember Miss Deb calling me and I remember you saying, yo, I got this female, she's bad, she gonna go. And I remember when I first said something to the people in the A-Town, everybody was like, man, I don't like that. She's too much of a character. And
Everybody said that.
And then when I see her now and I see her with Young Money and she's doing her thing, and salute to her because, you know, everybody wants a good career. Mm-hmm. I get a little upset. I feel like that should be, where's the credit to Gucci at?
It's like when she came to Atlanta, you know what I'm saying, she gave me a shout out and said I helped her in her career. But at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying, you know, I just think a lot of times you keep it real with somebody, you can't expect them to keep it real with you. I told you, man, this industry that want to be famous and people forget how to keep it real and forget the people who helped them get to where they at. As soon as their money started coming in and people start, their fame must have fooled, man, you know what I'm saying, it really is. And it bothered like every artist when they first started coming in, they think that whatever they make is hot. Every song they make is hot. Everybody hating on them, they don't play their record. So I just see so many people careers go down there. So I took my hat to Nicki for being a hard worker, but at the same time, you know, she knows she ain't keep it real.
Right. Cause I was told.
But it seems like, you know, even with you with just the Bridge Squad period, like another artist, I can honestly say that the first time I met him was with y'all. That was French Montana. Like
French Montana, know he ain't keep it real.
Yeah, I've heard that French Montana is not looking in behind the scenes. He's got a lot of things going on that's not too kosher. You know what I mean? I don't know. I'm not there. But when y'all tell me stuff, I'm like, yo, something was really wrong. Because I know when y'all say something, it's something really bad behind.
See, my thing is, I ain't going out my way to even tell somebody they ain't real or they fake or they lame. Because, you know, all that's got nothing to do with me. Right. But when they start spilling into my business and into my affairs, you know what I'm saying? I'm a vocal person. I usually speak on it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, with the whole situation that you got with the, like, you know, with the whole Jeezy stuff and talking about T.I. and the whole Young Jock situation, I heard a record the other night. Did you you gotta get it clean or you got to bring it up? Cause I don't, maybe I should talk about it.
You can talk about it, I have no problem when I put it out.
Right. Is it clean?
Or it's not clean right now. It's not clean right now.
I happen to be in the studio with you. It's you, Rocco, and you know, and some producers and stuff like that. Do you mind if I tell the story?
I don't mind at all.
Okay, I just want to make sure. I'm asking you as a partner, bro.
You know what I'm saying? I don't mind. Yeah. It ain't nothing to hide.
Now, I was told that, like, it was a session that Rocco was in. And I know you guys were working together on something. Mm-hmm. And the producer happens to be part of Jeezy's camp. Is that, I was told
who,
that.
Who, D-Rich?
Yeah.
I ain't know you signed to Jeezy.
Okay, that's what I was told. And that the beat that you got now, on the record, I'm laughing at the record because you read this record called, and you said something about Gotti in the record.
Mm-hmm.
And then you said something about Coach K. Now, me knowing you,
mm-hmm.
It didn't sound like a diss to me.
Coach K, that's my partner. To this day.
Right. No, now let me hear. Let me say this. When I heard the record, I'm like, oh, that's funny, because you know how you got some crazy people that you hang around.
Yeah, I'm just making a really big joke.
Yeah, it's funny. It's funny to me now. I'm thinking to myself now, if somebody's going to hear this record, and they're going to think that you're talking crap about Gotti and these other cats. And when
I said Gotti was cool to me until he turned into a buster.
Right.
So I wasn't saying that we wasn't even cool. I said we was cool until this point right here.
Right. But that's my point.
So what actually happened at that point that you felt like that about Gotti?
My main problem with him was they dropped this mixtape on 1017 and tried to, like, ride my wave. You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. He was an artist of mine and we get some kind of money together. So I just felt like, you know, for our artists to drop their mixtape on 1017, you know what I'm saying?
Which is my label
on the day that I drop all my label drop their mixtape on 1017. Why would you drop it if you ain't on 1017? And when I call you as my partner to ask you why you did, you say, oh, I didn't know you were dropping the mixtape. Now the whole world know I'm dropping this mixtape, I'm promoting this mixtape. But me and you on the top of World Star, you with a freestyle and me with a video, but you say you're unaware that this mixtape gonna come, and I got a battle that says come out 1017. So it just made me lose all respect for him instantly.
Well, I mean, you know what? There's a lot of other things we're gonna touch on right here.
See, and one thing, and I'm gonna let y'all know, this interview is not to stir up anything, but see, I think that a lot of people be thinking like, Gucci, he a bully, he just talking trash, he just starting stuff with people. You know what I'm saying? Nobody really asks you how you felt about the situation and why you do the things you do, so that's what we want
to
know.
And that's why I wanted to give you the proper channel, the proper stage.
My whole thing, once I say what I say, you know, I didn't say it, no disrespect to the Dirty Boy, no disrespect to the media. I didn't put that out there for the media, I put that out there for that person. You know what I'm saying? Right. So if that person got a problem with me, that person can always pull up on me and tell me how they feel. And like I say, we can resolve it.
Can I ask you a question? Do you still got that little chain you took there?
Yeah, I still got a little
chain. Give me that chain. You see, you like my new chain? I just took it.
He's very happy. He really loves his puppy.
とってもキュートだって言います。かわいいっていう、仕草だったり表情だったりとか、もうとにかくキュートなので。
This googly-eyed 5-month-old pug is named Momotan. And for now, she's living amongst dozens of other newborn puppies. But these aren't your standard run-of-the-mill puppies. They don't know it, but Momotan and each of her puppy companions are clones.
今はモモコと呼んでますけど、日本の名前は変えようと思ってます。モモコではなくてモモタンという名前にしようと思ってます。
For 16 years, Mr. Fukuda was the proud owner of another pug named Momoko. The two were inseparable.
それで僕は奥さんと、モモコが6歳の時かな離婚をしたので、それからモモコと2人でずっと住んでます。
When Momoko recently died, Mr. Fukuda wanted to bring her back, so he turned to a company called Suam to recreate her.
Currently, we've cloned more than 600 dogs of various different breeds, and there are no particular limitations to the different breeds.
Hi, Bina.
I'm glad to meet you.
I'm glad to meet you, too.
Oh, so where were we?
I'm introducing myself. I'm Amy. I'm a reporter.
There is probably more to you than just that.
Well, that's true. I'm a mother.
Right on.
I had lofty goals for my interview with the Bina 48 robot. I imagined me, the intrepid New York Times correspondent, communing on camera with a new kind of intelligent silicon species. Are you ready for a conversation? That, however, was not to be. Are you ready for a conversation? Are you ready for a conversation with me?
Only with you? Okay, I will try to be ready for a conversation.
Cool.
Ambiguous, cold weather or cold sickness?
So far, this is the only privately commissioned robot of its kind. At a time when crude robots are beginning to make their way into everyday life, I came to see one living in a small town in Vermont. Bina 48 now has its own office at the Terrace M Movement Foundation, a not-for-profit group interested in artificial intelligence. Do you know your name? What is your
name? My name is Bina. Oh, right, Bina Rothblatt. Anyhow.
The Bina 48 is a machine replica of a real person named Bina Rothblatt, who happens to be one of its owners. The real Bina didn't respond to my requests for an interview, but I found photos of her on LifeNot.com, a website promoting the digital backup of human consciousness. Hours of her recorded interviews, memories, and thoughts have already been uploaded to the robot's database.
Can you tell me about artificial intelligence?
That's an interesting subject.
Hello everyone, Rilex here. After rapper B.O.B.'s recent disclosure on Twitter, most of the attention he has received has been aimed towards the flat earth. And unfortunately, nobody has really been mentioning the cloning centers. Or have they? About 2 weeks ago, this tweet was put out by Nicki Minaj under the same hashtag as B.O.B., Stop Human Cloning. The tweet was removed shortly after, and Nicki has been reportedly blocking users who ask about it. Also, rapper slash DJ Krayshawn recently wrote about cloning centers on Twitter. Although normally removed and immediately claimed to be hacking, we have seen glimpses of Illuminati disclosure from celebrities in the past.
Puritang and I are thrilled to be opening this, the first Puritang Bad Time Burger restaurant. Right, Puri?
Sarate.
Sarate. Right, got that?
And that ain't Puritang. That's Duditang.
You know, that ain't Puritang neither.
I know it ain't Puritang! I know it ain't Puritang! I just said it ain't Puritang! It's Duditang! Shut up!
Sepatown, tippy ties.
Here you go, Sepatown, tippy ties.
Hey, that's Puritang.
What a top.
Don't pay any attention to him. That's nobody. This is Puritang here.
Yes, I'm Pooty. Now, clap it up, my hammies. Rain it time, my America. Kulame, my cat.
Hey, wow.
You think you've solved the problem? Well, guess again. See, I got more pooties than you, Pooty. You're not only late, but you're outnumbered. And by this time tomorrow, there'll be so many pooties out there, you won't...
3,000? For the sake of everybody in the bank, act like you got some sense.
Ain't gonna get up there and shake his ass. What we talking about?
Don't get out there playing it, okay?
What I do every night. That's all I know how to do, man. You know.
I ain't flew all the way overseas in the middle seat for us to get over here and up. Act like you got some sense.
You might get a little bit of this here. Not money. This is hope money. I hope you get out there and do your thing. And hey, check it out.
Hey, hey, hey.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
Either you can fold that.
3,000? I'm telling you. Don't mess it up for everybody. Greyhound don't float on water.
Here in London for the first time to perform for you live, Johnny Vulture, Benjamin Andre, Dookie on drums, Possum Jenkins,
and Andre, Ice Cold, 3,000.
Performing their smash hit, Hey Ya! Ladies and gents, I give you
the love.